Hello, and welcome to the September edition of Platts SBB Global Market Outlook. This month, the title is Crashing Raw Material and Chinese Steel Prices Set the Tone for Approaching Q4. In this edition, we look at what's been happening in August and early September. The key development was the headlong fall in iron ore prices from mid-August onwards, when prices moved below $95 dry metric ton to below $90 by the end of the month, and then to $82 a dry metric ton in mid-September. Scrap prices had been firmer in Turkey and Europe in August, but then they began to weaken in Turkey in early September. Meanwhile, US prices were steady, but Asian prices slipped. The result of the cheaper iron ore has been very competitive Chinese billets in many regions, including Turkey and the Middle East, as well as in Asia. In the US, flats prices were stable in August, but then slipped during the first half of September. European core prices dropped slowly during August, but then firmed, while Asian core prices fell. Longs prices in Europe have risen, but fell sharply in Asia in August, while rebar prices in US initially remained steady before spot levels began to rise later in August and September. So then, looking at the production figures from World Steel Association, they're for July, it's a longer month than June. Actual production fell by 0.9 million tonnes. Daily output was actually 4% lower. China produced 68.3 million tonnes. Now that's 2.2 million tonnes a day. China's output is slowing, and the July year-on increase is just 1.5%. Europe, that's the EU28, was sharply lower at 13.3 million metric tonnes of output. That's down 2% year-on-year. Spain saw a significant fall in its monthly output, but that's normal as it's their holiday month. US daily production was unchanged on June's level, but that's also a gain of 2.3% year-on-year. Putting those together gives a global total of 136.8 million tonnes. That's an increase of 1.7% from July 2013. So firstly, looking at flat products. In the US, the hot rolled coil spot market was stable in a narrow range for most of August, but spot prices began to weaken in early September as real demand did not improve as might have been hoped, and supply, including imports, appeared to rise. Inventories were lower than normal, but some destocking has already started and prices have continued to move downwards. In Europe, spot prices continued to slip during August. Then, some key mills announced a price increase in late August, which led to spot prices rising slowly. Buyers in Europe continue to purchase only when needed, but with low stock levels, there was a brief upsurge in demand from the start of September, which may continue. In Asia, regional flats prices fell heavily during August and early September as demand weakened. Prices and sentiment were affected by the continuing strong export volumes from China, with export price levels falling as domestic prices fell. Long products, prices for rebar, they dropped sharply in Asia during August and fell again in early September as more Chinese material, either rebar or billet, affected the markets. Prices have finally increased in Europe during August and September. Now, that's very late in the year for that to happen, but scrap levels may have an effect if demand remains lackluster. US mills held the rebar prices steady, but spot levels were rising in early September. So looking at raw materials, the iron ore is the key movement this month. Prices for iodex 62% were steady in early August, but before falling continuously during the rest of the month and into September, finishing even below $80 a dry metric ton late in the month. Chinese buyers are able to pick and choose when to buy, and there's plenty of material available from Australia and Brazil, as weather-related issues only appear later in the year. Perhaps the biggest surprise is that domestic mines appear to be still producing, despite prices being below their cost of production in some cases. And then scrap. US prices for shredded material have been stable again during August and early September, as the market remained in balance. This has continued for most of September, as mills await the next buy week. Turkish prices initially rose until buyers turned down the US exporters' high levels and then booked significant volumes when prices corrected. So Turkey's import price began to slip in early September. It's actually fallen sharply in the rest of the month. European scrap prices firmed slightly during August and early September, but Asian import prices slipped during August, rose slightly in early September as demand briefly improved, but levels have fallen back since then. And finally, looking forward, our first conference of the new season is our fourth annual steel supply chain conference in Antwerp, Belgium on October the 9th, as we mentioned last month. Now there is also a Platts Steel Forum in London as part of LME Week in the afternoon of Tuesday, October 21st. Further details of both events are on our website.